listen here, Dadana. A, first let me see this point. Last class, what did you study? Yes, definition of Cartesian product. So, the Cartesian product is also referred as cross product. This Cartesian product is also referred as cross product. Each and every word of the book is very important for the exams. Because while you are writing the competitive exam or when they are asking in 1 mark, you should be able to answer for the question. Then you have to study every line of the book. That is the correct method of learning. So let us continue this. The Cartesian product is also referred as cross product. So what is the other name of the Cartesian product? Cross product. What is the other name of the cross product? Cartesian product. So just while you are studying this also, you try to frame a question. You frame a question and try to answer for it. A cross B is the set of all possible ordered pairs. So what is meant by A cross B? Already we studied set of all possible ordered pairs. So it should be between two sets. So between the elements of A and B. It is between the elements of A and B such that first coordinate is an element of A. Why they have said coordinate? While you are representing the point in the graph. So you are writing in a pair, isn't it? So first you see here. This is pair. It is represented in a graph. So what will you say about this one? This is x coordinate. This is y coordinate. So this one is an element of A. This A is an element of set B. One is an element of set A. A is an element of set B. So the first coordinate is an, because since it is a pair, they are saying first coordinate. This first coordinate is an element of set A. The second coordinate is an element of B. A. You see here. This is the second coordinate is an element of B. Do you follow this? Next. B cross A. So first, if you are able to find A cross B, then what are you going to find? B cross A also you are finding out. So B cross A is a set of all possible ordered pairs. So this is also same thing. There is no change. Set of ordered pairs, set of all possible ordered pairs only. Both. But this is between the set of A and B. This is also same. That is the change. Such that the first coordinate is an element of B. Just you see here, B cross A. This first coordinate is an element of B. Next one, the second coordinate is an element of A. What is the second coordinate here? 1. 1 is an element of A, set A. Why they have not said here set A? Means because we know that set is represented with the capital letters. So, element of A. Next one, next point. In general, A comma B is not equal to B comma A. Just you see here, observe these two. A cross B, that is Cartesian product of A and B. Cartesian product of A and B, cross product of A and B. You can say like this or that also. Cartesian product of A and B or cross product of A and B. So what it is given, 1 comma A is not equal to A comma 1. When will it be equal? If A equal to B, if both are same elements, if both are same elements, then A comma B is equal to B comma A. Do you follow this? So illustration here it is given. Just you see here, illustration, let us see. A equal to 1, 2, 3. B equal to A, comma B. Right? A cross B and B cross A. So, A cross B. First, which set you have written? Yes, A set. Instead of this A, you are writing the set. What it is given in the question. Then, cross B. What is given here? B? A comma B. You are going to write it in an ordered pair. What are the possible ways that you have to do? If you don't know to write it like directly, just you can use arrow diagram also. You can use arrow diagram. Like this you can write. This is set A. This is set A and this is set B. What is given here set A? 1, 2, 3. This is set B. Here A, B. What are the possible ways? Those students, those who are not able to write it directly, you can use this method. Arrow, by using arrow. Arrow diagram. So, from 1, 1 is paired with A. Again, this 1 is paired with B. So, 1 comma A and 1 comma B. Is it okay? Is it okay or not? Next one. Next one is, just let me take this orange. 2 is paired with A and B. That is 2 comma A and 2 comma B. 2 comma A, 2 comma B. Next one is 3. You are taking from set A. So, what are the possible ways? 3 comma A and 3 comma B. Is it okay? Is it okay or not? So, here. But, in your book, they have given in graph formation. In graphical representation, they have given. You see here. This is one of the way. Because, this is the easy way to represent. But, you should know this also. First, set A is, the elements from set A is represented in X axis. This is X. This is Y. So, 1, 2, 3. This is what? Set A. This is set B. So, 1, 2, 3. Here, what are the elements in set B? A, B. So, you have to plot a point. What is this meeting point here? 1, then A. 1 comma A. First you have to start from the X coordinate. X coordinate you have to write first. While you are writing the ordered pair, the first element should come from X axis. The second element should come from Y axis. Next one is what? 2, then A. 2 comma A. Next one is 3 A. 3 comma A. Is it okay? Next. 1. What is here? B. This is the meeting point. This is the meeting point. From X and from Y. So, 1 comma B. Next one. 2 B. 2 comma B. Next one. 3 B. So, 3 comma B. Do you follow? This is A cross B. Next one is what? B cross A. So, first which set you have to take? B set. Which set you have to take? B. While they are asking, you have to write B cross A. First. First set is B. Second set is A. Second set is A. In B, what are the elements they have given? A, B. In set A, what are the elements given? 1, 2, 3. I told you, by using arrow, you can pair it very well. So, from A. A comma 1. Let me take A 1. Next, A 2. See here. A 1, A 2. Isn't it? Next. Sorry. A 1, A 2, A 3. Do you follow? A 1, A 2, A 3. Because how many elements are here? 3 elements are here. So, what is it? A comma 1, A comma 2, A comma 3. Sorry children. A comma 1, A comma 2, A comma 3. Next one, what you should take? B. B comma 1, B comma 2, B comma 3. B comma 1, B comma 2, B comma 3. Is it okay? So, how many pairs are here? 6. Here, how many pairs are there? 6. Here, 2 threes are 6. Here, 3 twos are 6. Just in graphical representation, graph. In graph, how they have represented, just you check. First, x-axis. This is y-axis. This is x-axis and this is y-axis. So, from x-axis, what you are taking? A. Y-axis, 1. So, what is the ordered pair? A comma 1. But here, what did you get? 1 comma A. Here, what are you getting? A comma 1. Again, I told you, while you are writing a pair, the first element, it has to come from x-axis. So, B, then what? 1, B comma 1. Next, A, 2, A comma 2. Next, B, B comma 2. Next, A comma 3, A comma, B comma 3. Otherwise, how you can write also another way? First, you take A, A comma 1. Next, A comma 2. Next, A comma 3. B comma 1. B comma 2. B comma 3. But you have to write all the possible ways. That's all. Huh? So, just you see here. Next one. In general, A cross B is not equal to B cross A. Cross product of A cross B is not equal to cross product of B cross A. But, N of A cross B is equal to N of B cross A. Cardinal number will be equal. I told you, here you see. Here also 6 possibilities. Here also 6. So, cardinal number. The number of elements in the given set. What is meant by cardinal number? The number of elements in a given set. You have to count it. How many elements are there in a given set. That is called cardinal number. N is nothing but the cardinal number. N of A cross B is equal to N of B cross A. But A cross B is not equal to B cross A. A cross B is empty if and only if A is equal to empty set or B is equal to empty set. Any one of these sets, if it is empty, then A cross B is empty. Suppose A is equal to X comma Y, B is equal to empty. Then what is A cross B? It is empty. Suppose A is equal to empty and B is equal to A comma B. Then what is B cross A? Empty. What is A cross B? It is empty. If any one of these, among these two, if any one is empty, then either A cross B or B cross A, it is empty only. Do you follow? Next one. This is very, very important thing. N of A is equal to P, N of B is equal to Q, then N of A cross B is equal to P into Q. PQ means what? P into Q. Do you follow? Suppose, this is a variable. Suppose you are putting a number. I told you here. Suppose, N of A is equal to, you see this example itself. N of A is equal to what? 3. N of B is equal to what? 2. I told you what is meant by cardinal number. Number of elements. Just you count it and write the number. That's all. 3, 2. So, what is N of A cross B? 3 into 2. So, 3 2s are 6. What is B cross A? What is B? 2. What is A? 3. So, 2 threes are 6. Do you follow this? Then, thinking corner. When will A cross B be equal to B cross A? When A and B are equal sets. When A and B are equal sets. What is meant by equal sets? Two sets are having exactly same elements. What is meant by equal sets? You have studied in 9th standard, I think. Huh? Equal sets means what? Exactly same elements. Suppose if A is equal to A comma B and B is equal to what? A comma B. The places it can be changed. You can write B comma A also. But the elements exactly same elements. Cardinal number also what? Same. Do you follow? Exactly same elements. But A comma B, here what you can have? B comma A also. The place it can be changed either in first position or second position, whatever it is. Do you follow?